So in this video, we're going to be looking at what hyaluronic acid injection is, also called as the rooster comb injections or the gel injection. We're going to see whether it's an effective treatment for knee osteoarthritis or not. And we're also going to look at what the research says about this treatment and whether or not it's worth considering. So before we dive in, let's talk about some basics about knee arthritis. So we all have some lubricating fluid inside the knee, and one of the components of the fluid is called as hyaluronic acid. In arthritis, this particular fluid is decreased, causing friction, resulting in inflammation, causing the swelling and pain. So it makes sense to put a lubricating gel inside the knee that should be able to decrease the swelling and inflammation. So what is the difference between hyaluronic acid injection and the cortisone injection? Cortisone injection, basically injecting a corticosteroid medication into the knee, basically acts like an anti-inflammatory, thereby helping to reduce the swelling and pain. So the easy way that I explain to my patients is think about putting a bottle of ibuprofen into your knee. Unfortunately, steroids has side effects. So some of the side effects include increased blood sugar, increased blood pressure, and theoretically it can cause cartilage degeneration if used repeatedly. So one can argue saying that repetitive cortisone injections can actually worsen arthritis. I've made an entire video on cortisone injections for arthritis and I've attached the link above. However, when you look at hyaluronic acid injection, it does not have the systemic side effects that is associated with cortisone injection, which is great, right? Yes, the hyaluronic acid injections can produce local side effects such as the arthritis flare-up, or can produce a local injection site pain and swelling. But without the concerns of cartilage degeneration, I think hyaluronic acid injection is a really good deal for knee osteoarthritis. So personally, I want these injections to work. So when we look at the evidence, most of the studies have compared hyaluronic acid injections with saline injections, and some have compared them with cortisone injections. I've linked the studies in the description box below. So basically, in summary, hyaluronic acid injection is not better than placebo in blinded studies. This means that in studies where patients don't know what they were getting, whether it was a placebo or a hyaluronic acid injection, the improvement in knee function did not differ much. However, unblinded studies, which means that our patients knew that they were getting a hyaluronic acid gel injection, they showed better results than placebo. So this questions the efficacy of the placebo effect. However, one unblinded study did not show a significant benefit when comparing a hyaluronic acid injection with a steroid injection. Observation studies that look at how patients are doing after hyaluronic acid injection do notice an improvement and justify the use of the injection. So based on the evidence, what do the experts recommend? The American Association of Orthopedic Surgeons, they do not recommend it. The American College of Rheumatology, they do not recommend as a first-line treatment. The European Society for Clinical and Economic Aspects of Osteoporosis and Osteoarthritis, they recommend if the patient is not getting benefit from medications alone. Osteoarthritis Research Society International, they recommend after discussing the risk and benefits of the patient. So there was one study, they found that repeat cycles of injections can provide more pain relief. So in a clinical scenario, if a patient reports that an injection helped a little bit at 6 month mark, but not much, it may be beneficial to try the injection again before concluding that it does not work. So this study found that there was almost a 10% increase in patients responding to the injection the second cycle. So in my clinical experience, cortisone injections are usually more effective when a patient has an acute arthritis flare-up, where they're having like a severe swelling and knee pain. The hyaluronic acid injections takes a lot of time to start working. And again, in theory, the hyaluronic acid injection is almost like putting a lubricating fluid inside the knee. It doesn't act as a quick anti-inflammatory like the cortisone injection does. So usually, cortisone injection are usually given for acute arthritis flare-up, and the patient has a nagging knee pain like in daily life, then I usually would consider giving the hyaluronic acid injection at that time. So when I do these injections, I'm hoping the best for my patient. I want my patients to keep moving because fitness is really important. So even if there's a remote chance that these injections would work, I would happily go for it. Okay, so my final take here is that, let us say if your insurance covers it, then just go for it. But let us say if your insurance doesn't cover this injection, before you pay the money for the hyaluronic acid injection, I would definitely take a look at the PRP and compare the cost and benefit between PRP and hyaluronic acid injection. Okay, I've attached the video about PRP here, and I've attached a video about cortisone injection here. And I'll see you in the next video. If you have any questions or comments, please post in the comment box below. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing. If If you want to get notified of my future videos, then please click the notification button, and I'll see you in the next video. Until then, goodbye.